we discussed about physical quantities. Many quantities have both value and direction. To describe these quantities, we need a special mathematical language, language of vectors. When somebody asks you for directions, you normally tell him, go 100 meters straight, turn left 50 meters, destination will be on your right. You have already used the language of vectors. Navigation of any sort is based on language of vectors. Movement of this toy car along a straight line can happen only in two directions. We can take its motion to be positive when it moves to your right. Its motion will be considered negative when it moves to your left. For aeroplane moving in space, positive and negative sign will not be enough. We must use vector. The name vector means carrier. In medicine, a mosquito is a malaria vector. Suppose a thing is carried 3 meters east and 4 meters north. Its displacement vector can be drawn like this. Vectors can be pictured as arrow connecting a place a thing is carried from to a place it is carried to. Vector is something which has magnitude or value as well as direction. Some physical quantities that are vector quantities are displacement, velocity, and acceleration. Not all physical quantities involve direction. Temperature, pressure, mass, and time do not point to any specific direction. We call these quantities scalars. Rules of normal algebra are applicable to these quantities. A single value with a sign specifies a scalar. For example, temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius. When 2 kilograms of wheat is added to 1 kilogram of wheat, we get 3 kilograms of wheat. Displacement or change in position is the simplest vector quantity. A vector that represents displacement is called displacement vector. If a toy car changes its position by moving from C to D, we say that it undergoes a displacement from C to D, which we represent with an arrow pointing from C to D. The arrow specifies the vector graphically. The displacement vector tells us nothing about the actual path that the particle takes. In this example, all three paths connecting points A and B correspond to the same displacement vector. Displacement vectors represent only the overall effect of the motion and not the motion itself. If you want to cross the river, which has a strong current, instead of going straight, you go at an angle. What angle? This is most easily described by vectors. Here, the blue vector represents the flow of the water. The red arrow represents the direction and speed with which you are swimming. The black arrow shows how you will actually travel. Scalars and vectors are very important concepts in physics. You will come across more such quantities in next standard.